One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. Hey everyone, this is going to be the first video in my Polyrhythms video series. In this video series, I will teach you various polyrhythms, explain what they are, and how to practice and use them. Very importantly, I will first and foremost teach you how to internalize them, which I find to be a big sticking point for so many musicians, especially when it comes to polyrhythms and multiple time fields at the same time. Then, I will also show you how to creatively use these polyrhythms in your playing, so that they actually become a tool in your toolbox, and not just some random musical concept you have no use for. If you're new to this channel, please consider subscribing. I release a lot of bread and butter videos with clear instructions on how to practice and improve your playing today. So, let's get into it. What are polyrhythms? What's a polyrhythm? Polyrhythm is a rhythm that makes use of two or more different rhythms simultaneously. Or in simple words, it's when you listen to the music and you hear one rhythm happening on the one hand, but then you're hearing another sort of independent rhythm happening on the other hand. And the two rhythms are somehow related in some intricate way, as in they're not just two random rhythms. So the first polyrhythm I would like to talk to you guys about today is the dotted quarter note. This is one of the most popular, widely used, and frankly still one of my favorite polyrhythms because it's just so cool and so useful. Before I talk about it anymore, let me demonstrate what this polyrhythm is. Check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four.
Here is the actual 4/4 time.
One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four. One, two, three, four, two, two, three, four.
Here is the dotted quarter note rhythm that keeps repeating and repeating across the bar lines, creating sort of a rhythm of its own. And here's what that sounds like.
1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4.
And now I will play you guys a combination of the two so that you will hear how the two are related and where the second one sits inside the first one.
1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 2, 2, 3, 4.
So now that you understand it logically, let's move on to ingraining it into your system, so to speak, because that will be a necessary step before you can apply it in your improvisations. Rhythm must be felt in your body. If you can't feel the rhythm in your body, then you won't be able to execute that rhythm on your instrument. And this applies to grooves, to polyrhythms, to syncopated rhythms, and every kind of rhythm. If there's some kind of rhythmic figure that you can't first sing over a metronome or clap over a metronome, then you certainly will not be able to execute that rhythm on your saxophone or piano or guitar. Your instrument should always be the last place where you practice rhythmic concepts. The rhythm has to be ingrained in your body first before you can execute it on your instrument. And here is why this is good news. This is good news because it means we can practice all these rhythms and polyrhythms away from our instruments. Because we don't really need our instruments to ingrain these rhythms into our minds and bodies. You can practice these rhythms in the shower or on the street or anywhere. And I will show you some incredible techniques to do that in just a few moments. So let's see how we make you understand and ingrain the dotted quarter note polyrhythm. And I'm going to teach you a foolproof method that I would teach an 8-year-old, just in case for those of you who need it broken down to the very, very bones. Get some staff paper and write out the dotted quarter note polyrhythm for, I don't know, 24 bars or whatever. Remember, notating this polyrhythm will go over the bar line. It will not align neatly within every bar. That's why it's a polyrhythm. Its phrasing doesn't line up with the 4-4 of each bar. Now, turn on the metronome and count out loud using the smallest subdivisions involved in this polyrhythm. Those subdivisions being eighth notes. So do this.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 1.
Now turn on the metronome again and count out loud just like you did before. Except this time, clap the polyrhythm off of the page in front of you, like this.
1 and 2 and 3 and 4 and 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 1.
Another way of practicing this is turn on the metronome and start walking in place to the tempo of the quarter note. And as you walk to the quarter note, start singing the dotted quarter note with your mouth, like this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Another way of practicing it is the way drummers practice, and that is with a left-right, left-right, left-right stroke. Turn on the metronome and start drumming eighth notes with your left and right hands, like this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
Then start accenting every 3 eighth notes, which is essentially accenting every dotted quarter note. Right? Remember, a dotted quarter note is 3 eighth notes. Something like this.
1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4.
But okay, now that you internalized it, what is it even good for? How can we use it? Here are a few cool and creative ways of applying the dotted quarter note polyrhythm in your playing. First, you can use it in your solo lines, which means straight up playing dotted quarter notes across the bar line in your solo and introducing that polyrhythm as an improvisational device. Something like this. Another way I like to do it is playing it with my left hand as a walking bass line. That's right, a polyrhythmic walking bass line. Instead of walking quarter notes in my left hand, I'll go ahead and start walking dotted quarter notes in my left hand, like this. While we're at it, why not apply it to some stride piano as well, like this. Many more creative ways of using this polyrhythm in arranging, accompanying, composing, but I hope you sort of get the idea by now. One thing I will say, that to do this kind of stuff effectively, you need to have really good time. And if you're curious on how to develop really strong time, I have a video for you right here where I go into great detail on how to practice time and develop an ironclad time feel in your playing. Check it out.